So I would define botanical medicine pretty simply. I mean, using herbs, botanicals, so herb in some ways can refer to part of a plant, but I just mean using a plant to elicit some kind of change inside a person. And so in some cases, that can be very basic. That could be somebody going into the garden and smelling a plant. It could also be taking a plant, isolating down a plant chemical, putting it in a capsule in a way that almost looks like a drug. And so botanical medicine spans that whole spectrum for me. So with the opioid crisis today, there's a couple of issues. The first is pain. A lot of people have pain. Maybe most people have some kind of pain. And so we can't just say that we need to stop people from using opiates without replacing it with something to adequately address their pain. So here at SCNM, we try to do a combined approach. We might look at nutritional factors, we might look at lifestyle, stretching, adjustments, to try to figure out, you know, how we can address the pain in a holistic way. And part of that is certainly botanical medicine. So, of course, opiates came from a botanical, the opium poppy, and there's a lot of other herbs that have a similar mechanism of action to opium, for example, but that are less addictive that we might consider. And then there's a host of herbs that have other mechanisms of action that might target the inflammation, the spasms, some of the other things that can play in to that pain that the patient's experiencing. The other piece to that is the possibility of addiction with opiates. And so for some people, they were given opiates to treat pain and that worked and they ended up on them. And it can be hard to come off of those medicines. And so we can use the herbs and really another holistic type treatment approach to help people decrease the dose of those opiate medications safely by minimizing the side effects and withdrawal symptoms that they might experience.